You've probably seen this distortion on the poles of the sky in every game engine, even if the sky texture itself looks good. This distortion is the result of mapping a texture onto a sphere, and I will show you how to fix it completely by using cube mapping. I'll use Godot to demonstrate, but this happens in most game engines for similar reasons. The most common method for mapping a texture onto a sphere is equirectangular mapping. It uses latitude and longitude, like a map of the Earth. You can see that the texture distorts at the poles because all the longitude lines converge to a single point. Equirectangular mapping stretches this point to infinity across the top and bottom edges of the texture. This wastes space and causes distortion because there's more longitude resolution than latitude resolution. This distortion happens even if you use higher resolution textures, and many people just paint over the poles in a solid color to hide it, instead of actually fixing the issue. To fix the poles completely, instead of trying to wrap a flat texture around the sphere, you can project the environment onto the six faces of a cube. This technique has minimal distortion and is supported in many game engines. But one disadvantage is that cube maps are less common than equirectangular maps, so you often need to convert them and rearrange or rotate the cube faces until they look right, since assets and game engines may order them differently. Now I'll show you how to convert an equirectangular map into a cube map in Blender. You can grab the finished .blend file in the description. Now I'll walk you through how to set up and how to use it. So the first thing you want to do is select the default cube, or delete it and create it again if you prefer. Go to edit mode, mark all edges as seams, and UV unwrap, so just press U twice. Then reorient the faces to match the format required by your game engine. So like this. You need to make sure that all the vertices line up, because if you zoom in, you can see that when you're zoomed out, this looks like one vertex, but it's actually four vertices. So what you want to do is you want to scale them by zero, so they're all in the same place. And you go through and you do that for each of these vertices to make sure there's no gaps. And you also need to make sure that these vertices are in the correct position, because it may say that it's at 0.5 or 0.666, but actually, if you click on it, it's actually at 0.664 instead of having all sixes. So what you want to do is you want to set this to 2 divided by 3, and now it's the correct value. And for the other vertices, you'll see something similar. So here it's 1, and this is not 1, it's 0.999, so you need to set that to 1. So just go through all of these vertices and make sure they're scaled to 0 and that they are at the correct position. Now I'll show you how the material is set up. If you're following along, just copy this node setup. Also make sure that the interpolation is set to linear or closest, because cubic or smart will blur the texture. And in sampling, turn off denoising and set the samples to about 64. Increase it until increasing it further doesn't make a difference, and just set it to the last value. Now, to actually bake the texture, so we have this equirectangular map right here, and we want to bake it into a cube map. First thing we need to do is we need to create a texture to which we're going to bake to. So this map is 8192 by 4096, and if you look at the cube, you see that horizontally, this map fits four cube faces. When you create a new texture, the dimensions you want to give it is 8192 divided by 4. And since the UV map horizontally has two cube faces, we're going to multiply it by 2. And we do something similar for the height. But since you have three cube faces, we multiply by 3. If your image is a PNG, don't check this checkbox. But if it's an EXR, then check this checkbox. What it does is it uses a 32-bit flow for your image. And this is important because if you're using an EXR or some other format that has like high dynamic range, and if you don't check it, then the bright parts will be clipped. So now we just press new image and we have our texture. To actually bake to this texture, we need to select the node with the new texture selected, and need to make sure that the cube is selected. If the cube is not selected, then you'll get an error. See, no valid selected objects. So you select the cube, you select the node, and you press bake. and it is baked. We have this texture here, and now we want to save it. So save as, and save to wherever your Godot project is. So in the color, just set whatever the input image uses, so RGB, the color depth, same as the input image, that's it. In general, make sure to set the file format to that of your input image. So for EXR, just set it to EXR. For the color, set it to the same as your EXR, and for color depth, set it to the same as the EXR. But if you want to save space and don't mind some loss of dynamic range, then select half. For codec, select zip to have lossless compression. If you're using EXR, make sure to set this checkbox based on your input image. But by default, it may be checked on, but if your image is using full float precision, make sure it's checked off. If it's using half float, then check it. If you leave this checked, even though it's full float, when you actually go to save the baked cube map, you may save it as a full float and think it's a full float. But actually, this checkbox was checked, so it's in reality a half float. And that's it. Now, if you want to go the other way around and you want to bake a cube map to an equirectangular map, first thing you want to do is you want to make sure there's no seams going on. So far, this texture looks okay. But for some other textures, you may notice. So basically, if it's set to closest, it'll look okay. But if you set it to something like linear, seams start to appear. This is one cube face. What's happening is that the interpolation interpolates across the face on the texture. So these pixels are interpolating across here, and these ones are interpolating across here. But since when we interpolate here, it's not a nearby face, it's a completely different face. What happens is that it causes a seam, because here it's supposed to be interpolating to another green face. I mean, instead it's interpolating to a blue face. But if you set it to closest, there's no linear interpolation. So you can see the individual pixels. That's why you need to make sure it's set to closest. In the fill and pixel filter, set it to box, because the other ones will blur the texture. And you put a camera. And in the camera, you want to set it to panoramic and panoramic type to equirectangular. For the resolution, so here we have two faces at the bottom, and it's 4096 resolution. So we set it to 4096 divided by 2. That's the size of one face. And then we multiply it by 4, since you have 4 cube faces in an equirectangular map. And that will give us 8092. And for the vertical resolution, we set the horizontal resolution divided by 2. So 8192 divided by 2. And then we just press render, and it renders the texture. So here we have the equirectangular version. And if you look around, like here, here we previously saw seams. But if you look at the same spot in the texture, see, there's no seams. And then you just save this same as we did before. Just save it, select the same settings, and that's it. Make sure to save your project if you're copying the node setup, because the textures are quite big and you might run out of RAM and crash. Also, set it to either CPU rendering or GPU render and see which one allows you to render the full image. Now I'll show you how to set up the textures in Godot. Let's say we imported this texture here. This is for the cube map. By default, it'll be like texture 2D. And we're going to set it to import as a cube map. In the compression, set it to VRAM compressed and turn high quality on. This will greatly reduce the memory usage. Turn on nitmaps and keep the arrangement the same, because the Blender file in the description already handles the arrangement. Godot by default doesn't have a cube map sky material. So what you want to do is we're going to create our own material. This is really easy. You just need to just change a few variables in the default material. So here, create a panorama sky material, and we click convert to shader material. We select the shader here. What we want to do is we want to change sampler 2D to sampler cube. And here we want to change sky chords to either. This will allow us to drag the cube map into the source panorama slot. So you can see that when we drag it in, it is highlighted as blue. But if we didn't do these changes, we would not be able to drag it in. But we can drag in the equirectangular map. Another thing is that if you look at this texture, you will see that it's really grainy. To fix this, We want to change filter linear to filter linear map anisotropic. See, the texture is already much better. There's no blurring. And what we want to do is also change the mipmap bias to negative 0.5. This will improve the crispness of the texture. So if it's at 0, it's not as crisp, but if you set it to negative 0.5, right, it will become just slightly crisper. If you set it to negative 1, then it will become slightly grainy, so that's why you set it to negative 0.5. The thing is, for most textures, you can keep it at filter linear without mipmaps if it doesn't have any fine details. Like a normal sky texture, like clouds, that'll probably be fine. Right? But if you have something like a starry sky, lots of these fine details, then you have to set it to filter linear mipmap anisotropic. This whole video, I've been showing equirectangular maps with mipmaps enabled. By default, mipmaps are not enabled. So you see it's really grainy. If you wanted to actually fix the grain, right, and make the texture look nice, you would need to enable mipmaps. But the problem is that if you enable mipmaps using a equirectangular map, it will cause a stretching at the poles, and it'll cause a seam as well, the bottom pole as well. You can't fix this by using equirectangular mapping. So even if you set this to filter mipmap anisotropic, it is a bit better, but you still see the stretching, and you still see the seam. This can only be fixed by using a cube map. So even with just using mipmaps, the Cubemap already looks better. And using anisotropic just makes it slightly better around the edges. And that's why you need to use a equirectangular map. As I said, I just used mipmaps throughout the video to show you the issue. By default in Godot, this doesn't happen. For things like sky textures, if there's not that many details, it'll look fine. But the goal of the video is to show the issues that come up with equirectangular mapping. So if you do something like a starry sky, you'll have either graininess or blurriness and so on, right? So this is how you fix some of these issues. But for something like a sky with clouds, you might just use an equirectangular map and have no issues at all. In that case, you might just skip converting to Cubemap and just use it directly. So this is how you would approach working with equirectangular maps now. Let's say you download it from a website like Polyhaven. You import it into Godot and you check if there's any issues. If there's any graininess, then you can convert it to a cube map and you create the shader as I showed and you customize the settings. That would fix the graininess. If you have no issues, then you could just continue using a equirectangular map. So that's it.